This is EA. Hello again, and welcome, Rich Lerner, alongside my friend and colleague. Golf courses in the United States. We're in the state of Washington,
Rich, which is magnificent. This is a walking golf course, so it's a chance to get out there, strut your stuff, and see if you got a game to match.
It's Scotland. Here we're in the northwest part of the United States, though.
Yeah, but Scotland's it's transferred a little piece of.
Thank you.
presented by EA Sports and the PGA Tour. Frank, every golfer wants to play it at least once, the old course at St. Andrews.
Yeah, from Bobby Jones to Jack Nicklaus to Tiger Woods, they've all come and conquered.
Frank, this is no ordinary opening tee shot. This is the opening shot at the old course at St. Andrews. So are you inspired, intimidated, nervous? Where are the emotions at?
Oh, all of the above. And this opening tee shot will never get old, that's for sure. It looks like a wide open hole. Really, you don't want to be looking right or left because it's out of bounds, even though it's a well way right and a long way left. You basically aim it at the 17th green as a good line for your opening tee shot.
Frank, did you hear the sound of that coming off the club face?
It was like a cannon.
Good contact, good result.
Rich, these winds haven't subsided at all today. It's certainly a tough test out there right now for these players.
They get your attention, don't they, as a player?
They have club selection right now, vital.
You put the ball back in your stance just a little bit?
If you're going to hit it down. Yeah, Rory's like a car that just has an extra gear. You know, if you've got five-speed gearbox, Rory's got six. If you've got a six-speed gearbox, he's got seven.
He's the souped-up Ferrari or Lamborghini. He can go. He's Formula One. And he went for the brief swim there, Frank. He's trying to stay dry now.
He is. Just trying to avoid water on the brain as well. This will take a good swing.
Third shot now after the last one found the deep blue.
Yeah, you can still minimize the damage here. It's only one bad shot that you got punished for.
Frank, that ball's sitting up like it's on plush carpeting.
Rich, if you and I had lies like that every time, we'd still be playing this game for a living.
That one needs to hit a tree or something because it is headed out of bounds.
Well, this is a humbling game, isn't it, Frank?
Well, that's out of bounds and it'll cost him a shot.
He's making a complete mess of this hole. Fifth shot. This one better be on the green.
Today's coverage brought to you by EA Sports and the PGA Tour. We're here in Fife, Scotland, known to many as the home of golf. They've been playing the game here since the 15th century. Today, here at the old course at St. Andrews, this historic links land will be the battleground for the most decorated golfers of the modern day. Rich Lerner alongside my partner, Frank Novello for EA Sports, will be calling all the action out here today. Frank, when you think of St. Andrews, what sort of memories come to mind?
Rich, I think you've got to think of the Swilken Bridge first and foremost, and that's a little bridge that crosses the burn as you go down the 18th. Every great player that's ever played this game has walked across that bridge and had a look back. And it's just a golf course that continually grows on you. This is where the game started, and it's a monument forever and a day.
And that Swilken Bridge has connected the generations from Jones to Jack, from Jack to Tiger. EA Sports is proud to present PGA Tour coverage. Hello again and welcome, Rich Lerner, alongside my friend Frank Novello. We are at the home of golf, Scotland, the old course at St. Andrews. Frank, what are some of the distinctive features to this wonderful old course?
I think when you just sort of look at the bullet points, people are going to look at the shared greens and how huge they are and the pot bunkers, but It has the most famous par four in the world. That's the road hole. And, of course, it has the most famous bunker, which is the road hole bunker. You couldn't build it today, hit across the corner of a hotel and hit it to a green that's got a road behind it, but it works. There's out of bounds over there.
He needs to get lucky. Frank, you're in the business of analyzing golf shots. Well, just needs to refocus right here. Out of bounds on that last shot, needs to keep this one in play. So playing the third shot right now after having gone OB. Well, this one has a chance to be really good. That's a good spot right there.
Center cut.
That is tasty looking right there, Frank. Just a perfect spot in the fairway.
That is prime real estate. How do you get a lie like that? Seriously, you could hit any club from there.
Another good swing, and it looks like, Frank, another really good shot. That will be a great look at birdie. Frank, this first hole, all about the swoke and burn.
Yeah, it cuts in so close to the front of that putting surface. If there's just a puff of wind, then all of a sudden that burn that you could just step across very much comes into play.
Standing over this putt, concentrating on the read.
Well, we'll never know if that had gone in, because it never made it.
Shouldn't be a problem here, but not a formality either. Henrik lining this one up, and it's for birdie. Plus one in the early going. Just a little tap in here. Workmanlike hole. He walks away with a par. Here we are now at the second. Always so important to try and establish a good round in these opening holes, Frank.
In the second hole, especially with the prevailing breeze and today's modern equipment, the odd player has actually driven this green, but you really see the tone of the golf course. The middle of the golf course is protected. There's a series of bunkers down there, but the left is always the safe side of the golf course, but the best line to play your second shot from on the whole golf course is always the right side, and we see that here at the second. That's an absolute beauty.
That is a monster hit right there. He carried that more than 350 yards. Second shot coming out of the rough here. This could be a good one.
I mean, the skill, and that was sublime.
Just good hands, coming out of the rough, able to manage the dip.
McIlroy does now with his second.
This is an 80-yard shot with a little wind coming from behind. This is a good-looking shot. Just needs to keep it steady here over the putt. Frankie took plenty of time on this birdie putt. He looked at it from three different angles. He forgot one very important ingredient.
Yeah, pace. You can definitely fall in love with the line, even with approach shots as well, but obviously we see it more on putting.
Good score going, now at 2 under par.
Any chance now for Jordan Spieth.
Even par early on. Just a couple of feet. In for par. Frank, talk about the strategy off the tee here at the third.
You can drive the ball pretty close to this green, Richard, shorter than the second hole. Just hit it down the right side, but try and avoid those little pot bunkers.
Beautiful looking shot right here. Frank couldn't ask for anything more.
Just the lie there, too. It is sitting up like it's teed up.
come on, that's not even human. That's ridiculous. That is 350-plus yards.
Second shot from the rough. It's on the way.
This looks like it's going to find the target.
How good was that, Frank, from the rough?
Oh, that's amazing. That's a masterclass in short game.
Second shot. Good look at the green.
Second shot.
Eight-foot putt here. Makes the putt and goes to one under. Settles in over the putt. Shouldn't be a problem here. Frank, this is the kind of start every player wants.
Yeah, swinging it well. Certainly hitting the ball in the right place there. And, yep, good thing, too. He's actually putting well. Even par, currently.
Still even par for the day. Frank, now at the fourth hole.
Yeah, long par four. Two choices, whether he's game enough to drive it down the right or down the left, which is a much wider piece of fairway.
He has given this one the full treatment. Perfect release through the ball. And this shot, he is on the fairway over 300 yards.
Winding this one up. Does he have the power, though?
Wow, what impact. Absolutely crushed it.
Oh, huge. Ooh. Huge with a capital H.
Busted that. Be a little disappointed with that because it lands in the rough and it appears to be fairly thick over there. I really love the caddies at St. Andrews, wisecracking old-timers. Guy hits a shot hard into a gorse bush on the left, and he turns to the caddy and says, "Is that okay?" And the caddy says, "Does it look okay?" Hit another one. Another instance, guy was stuck between two clubs. 6-iron, 7-iron. 6-iron, 7-iron, back and forth. Finally, he chose the 7-iron, hit it about 15 yards in the ground, and the caddy looked at him and said, "I guess we'll never know, Lottie, will we?" Good swing, good shot yet again.
That is an excellent play right there. The approach, giving him another good look.
Second shot coming out of the rough here.
So just 100 yards away, now the second shot.
Pretty good all day from this distance, just trying to take care of business. I don't know, maybe lifted right there, just sort of peaked. See if Spieth can knock this in for his par. Stays at one under with that par. 11 feet away. Not a gimme, but well within his range. How about that? 4 under par. Drops it, and he's at even par. Hole number 5 of the first par 5 we've seen today. This fairway looks like it narrows quite a bit, Frank. Are you thinking eagle when you step up onto the tee?
Well, you could, especially if you've got a little bit of breeze behind you. But it's quite wide in the driving area, with the exception of those 3 bunkers on the right that just sort of pop out. But if you can get it past those, this par 5, very reachable.
Now that is a really good tee shot right there, Frank.
I think that tipped the 300-yard mark.
John Daly, take a back seat, big fella. How about that drive?
Is it stopped yet?
It's still going.
I mean, that is a monster hit right there. He carried that more than 350 yards. Now from a good position in the fairway, his second shot. This one looks like it's headed right for the middle of the dance floor, Frank.
Rather nice shot, I would say.
And a chance for eagle after that perfectly played shot. This could be a huge momentum swing here, Frank.
Yeah, one more good swing, and he's going to have an eagle putt coming up. I know you don't want to get ahead of yourself, but it is well on the cards. Are you for real? It was terrible.
Frank, I'm not saying he should pull out driver here, but this is a long putt.
Greens are fast, though. You never know. Good line, good pace. Might have a chance.
So a long putt there and just didn't read it quite right. Getting set now over the putt. Well, not quite. Didn't hit it firm enough. This for Jordan Spieth's birdie. The barrel, and now the 2 under. And a Ben Crenshaw right there, just so smooth.
Never played before.
These putts keep the round together. Just a couple of feet. He'll take par and move on. Now to the 374-yard par 4 sixth, another scoring opportunity.
Hey, just be very careful of the wind conditions here, because that'll affect the strategy off the tee, but bunkers left and right to be avoided.
That appeared to be a good strike right there, Frank.
Oh, good. It's just towering. Look at that hanging in the sky. Great Bobby Jones used to say the hardest shot in golf's the next one. Judging by that light, it's not going to be too hard.
Frank, this is just a pleasure to watch. A player hitting on all cylinders at the top of his game.
Notice it's just flowing, too. There's not a lot of deep analysis going through his mind. Just one step in front of the other. If your swing's there, you don't have to find it. If your putting stroke's there, you don't have to find it. Just let it happen.
He makes a great pass at the golf ball. It's powerful, but it's rhythmic at the same time.
That's an absolute beauty.
Come on, that's not even human. That's ridiculous. That is 350-plus yards. Seems to like it. Headed for the fat part of the green. That is classy.
Not a chance of going in.
Getting set for another approach. Our featured golfer really looks dialed in at this point.
Yeah, right now, this is a great feeling to have as a golfer. Your swing's good, the timing, it's almost like it's just completely natural. You don't have to think. The swing is exactly where you want it to be. So really, you're just looking at the flag in front of you. Second shot.
Needs a pair of binoculars to see the hole.
pretty good stroke right there. Just hit it through the break.
Well, it's that sort of distance. If it goes in, it's a bonus.
Just needs to keep it steady here over the putt. With authority, count it as a par and two under. Birdie. Continues to amaze. Yet another birdie. And what a day it's been. Clean this up with a tap. Did the job right there. Continuing from the oldest championship in the game. It's the Open Championship at the old course at St. Andrews here at the seventh hole now, Frank.
Yeah, you try and hit your tee shot over a little stone there. It's called the March Stone. That's a good line for, like, left of center. And, well, if you can just work it off that, good tee shot. You're only going to have a pitch in here to a green that's set up very high.
He has given this one the full treatment. Perfect release through the ball. And this shot is on the fairway, over 300 yards. I mean, that is a sight to behold. What a spectacular shot we just saw on the par four with a drive in one. Seems to like it. Looks like it's headed for the green. This is a long putt. Really, the key is the speed. If it drops, that's a bonus.
That's a bit offline in the rough. Issue would be a lack of concentration or focus. Speed wasn't bad on that long putt, but the read wasn't very good. This requires a lot of speed through the ball. This is a cross-country special. Well, Frank, it's our job to get excited.
You can't. You can't when you leave it short, though.
I'm sad.
He's making my job hard. Really? This is an awkward length.
That hurts. Just hammered that par putt, Frank.
Well, I don't know what he was thinking or what was going through his mind right there, but he better wake up in a hurry, because if this one doesn't go in, then that score's going to rack up very quickly.
Birdie putt now for Henrik Stenson. Standing over this putt, concentrating on the read. This for bogey. And with that, one under par.
Even par currently.
Just like that, with a bogey, goes from level par to one over. Frank, now at the par 3 eighth, and how challenging is this hole?
Well, it's called short on the scorecard, but massive green. The problem here is trying to hit it close. A lot of little subtle breaks and undulations in this green, and often you see long, long birdie putts here.
Just a beautiful approach shot. Frank, over the course of the last 15 years or so, there have been a number of initiatives within the game of golf just to try to grow the sport.
Yeah, we've seen the PGA Junior League, which is a series of competitions, obviously, for juniors to play. But the first tee really is worldwide now, just to try and introduce players from all over the world into the game of golf. They're introduced with club professionals. They learn skills that are essential, really, to play the game of golf. But in 2014 was a real step, what I think, in the right direction to showcase the junior talent around the world with the drive, chip and putt, where you actually get a chance to play the drive, chip and putt final at Augusta National, the home of the Masters.
Imagine young kids, boys and girls, 8 years old, 11 years old, being able to go, hey, I have something in common with Jack Nicklaus, with Arnold Palmer, with Phil Mickelson, with Tiger Woods. I won at Augusta National Golf Club.
Should be safely on deck.
It's 180 yards now to the flagstick. Settles in over the putt. Yeah. So begins the climb back. This for Jordan Spieth's birdie. -2 for the day. Shouldn't be a problem here. Just an amazing display. The records continue to fall. Always so important to finish your first nine holes on a positive note here at the Open Championship.
Yeah, the ninth hole, this is the most extreme part, furthest away from the clubhouse, in the middle of the loop here. A good drive, though, that avoids those bunkers has every chance of finding this par four with your tee shot.
Well, this looks good.
Certainly is.
Frank couldn't ask for anything more.
Just the lie there, too. It is sitting up like it's teed up.
Frank, going back 100 years or more, we used to see winning scores in stroke play tournaments, 72-hole events of 300, thereabouts. But obviously, like so many things in golf, everything has improved.
Yeah, people would scoff at sort of saying 475s would win a U.S. Open or a British Open. It didn't, and it does. But, you know, with equipment, and people have really got into the game, they've worked it out. And they just playing got better at it. They realized that, you know, stroke play, you can't just, you know, swing from the trees, so to speak. You've really got to work your way around and get better. You just can't sort of settle for mediocrity.
That's the equivalent of a 98-mile-per-hour fastball in baseball. This one just smoked 325 yards. Here's to be what they call a commercial play. Very solid.
So this one down within a couple of feet. Pretty good all day from this distance, just trying to take care of business.
Henrik lining this one up, and it's for birdie. Just a couple of feet.
Really moving in the right direction at 3 under.
So we're getting set now for the second nine here at the old course at St. Andrews. And Frank, a chance to get off to a good start here with the short par 4-10th?
Yeah, it's a very subtle hole. It just looks straight ahead in front of you, but there is gorse down the left if you stray, especially into a head breeze. But really, it's drivable for most of the players. Just got to worry about those two bunkers. There's a sort of short right of the green. You finish up there, then this hole becomes a little more difficult. Tom Weisskopf was one of my idols growing up. I loved the way he swung. That swing right there reminds me of my idol.
I mean, looks like Rory McIlroy finds stick in the follow-through.
I've seen some long tee shots, but the advantage to tee that ball up, get it up there quickly, get the wind behind you, it's amazing how far you can hit it.
Well, the tee shot has landed in the bunker.
That's an absolute beauty.
Setting up for the shot from the sand. So the second of the par four goes begging, and now I'll have to rely on the short game.
Yeah, but a short game, as we all know, can redeem a lot of mistakes. See if he does it here.
That should be pretty good right there. On the safe side, doing whatever he wants with that golf ball, moving it left, moving it right, hitting it straight when it's called for. He's doing it all. Jordan Spieth now on the approach shot. This, the second shot here at the par four. Getting ready for the putt. Henrik Stenson for par. Good chance here. Makes birdie, continuing to amaze on the greens, Frank.
Putted well all day, Rich. Had a couple of good holes early on and just, I think, found the groove. It's taken it to another level.
How about that? Four under par. Hole number 11, the Eden, is really the finest.
This hole has been copied by many an architect for the reasons why it's normally very, very difficult to make a hole of this length, or should I say this short, so difficult. But they've managed to do that here at Eden with that Strath bunker in the front and the severe sloping on either side of that bunker.
Boy, that can really be brutal, can it?
It certainly does. And if you have any doubt there, you'll come unstuck at 11.
Wow, Frank, he is dialed in.
Yeah, that was just some shot on that. Easy birdie.
This shot, 170 yards. Hit, wrong club. What happened there, Frank?
All the above, maybe. It's a little bit of a head scratcher. Wasn't that hard a shot.
This is a good looking shot. Wow, really off the mark. Missed the green here. Frank, how about that?
Well, can you believe that, too? I mean, could have hit the flag and bounced away instead. Straight in. Amazing shot. And really deserves it.
Just a beautiful roll there.
Oh, that's like stealing.
Really not much to this. The only issue would be a lack of concentration or focus.
Putting a good round together now at 4 under.
Now at the 12th, and Frank, when you put the peg in the ground here, are you licking your chops?
Well, you are, unless you're playing into a head breeze, because if you are playing a head breeze, then you've got to worry about the 4 bunkers that are in the middle of this fairway. Touch of help, or if you're a long hitter, then all you've got to do is worry about that little pot bunker just short of this green. There is gorse left and right, though.
Drivable par 4, not for most in this field, but for this guy, yes, he has just knocked it on. What a shot.
This is definitely not going down the fairway.
It doesn't look good. I think it's going to be in the deep rough. They'll pay a little bit of a price for missing the fairway here, because from that rough, you cannot control the spin on the golf ball. Straightforward pitch shot here, 35 yards.
See if he can give his round a real big boost. This putt is for eagle.
You couldn't ask for much more than that, except to make it. 8-foot putt here.
Well, in the words of the late, great baseball commentator for the Yankees, Phil Rizzuto, it's time for...
Holy cow, Whitey! That's 11 under par.
That's a birdie for McIlroy. He's just so explosive. Over the putt, this is Jordan Spieth.
Oh, yes, that's an eagle. Moving on now to the par 4 13th. Frank, what's the strategy here?
Once again, to avoid those pot bunkers, the first one is called Nick's, and then the other two up ahead, once again, they're called the Coffins. Somehow you've got to go right or left of those or beyond those. If you can go in the exact right position, which is slightly left center, you will actually have a full view of this green. A left or right of that, then it's a blind second shot.
What was he thinking there?
I have no earthly idea.
That is massive off the tee.
Meters, yards, I don't care how you measure that. That's got to be, what, 300 meters, 325 yards, something like that.
Second shot coming out of the rough here.
There's out of bounds over there.
He needs to get lucky.
Well, no other way to say it, Frank. Frank, this is always such a difficult spot for a golfer. You just hit one out of bounds, you're trying to regroup.
He's going to need to more than regroup now.
Getting set now for his fourth shot. Took the penalty after hitting it out of bounds.
Yeah, this can get away from him here.
By heart of the green. A good 190-yard shot, and this is the second.
Frank, looks like he came over just a little bit.
Yeah, that one wasn't pretty, but it's still gonna get away with it.
This is the second shot at the par four.
Frank, I'm not saying he should pull out driver here, but this is a long putt.
Greens are fast, though. You never know. Good line, good pace. Might have a chance. Oh, that was nasty.
That's an outrage right there. I mean, if there's a high commission of golfdom, we need to consult them right now, because it's just simply not fair, Frank. It's not.
I think the people above are frowning on the people below.
That hurts. Very well done. Almost made it.
Yeah, there'll be no stress for the next one.
Locked in on the read and the speed.
That's plain not fair.
Boy, this game is cruel, Frank. You get on a roll and then smack. Hits you right in the face and knocks you down. Good chance here. Currently at 5 under par. Starting to put something special together. 6 under par. Just a little tap in here. Stenson has this for par. Frank, what's the strategy here at the 14th?
If you can't go for this par 5 and 2, Rich, there is another option where you can go left. And I mean left of left. That's down the fourth fairway. That's across the Elysian Fields, as they call it, which is a set of hummocks that run down the middle. And you can find a flat lie there and come across at about a 45-degree angle for your third shot to 14. I'm loving that balance.
Oh, this looks good.
Certainly is.
Frank, can one small tweak from an instructor lead to a big turnaround?
With the right player, yeah. You just want to hear the right message. It's like anyone in life. You just want to be pointed in the right direction.
This is all feel with a lob wedge. That one is in the bunker. Nice position, short grass, second shot. Crucial eagle attempt on the way. Right in the heart of the fairway, green light special.
What a great shot.
Now ready for the explosion shot. Pretty long putt right here. You'd be happy to get it to within 2-3 feet.
Looks like he just misread that. This would give him an eagle on the card. Oh, I thought he had that. Yeah, that's a good putt right there. From that distance, he'll settle. And it's a long way to the hole from here. Never easy. That looks good. Might like it. Oh, they're going to love it. What a putt.
This one just requires a little bit of focus.
Just an amazing display. The records continue to fall.
He can really get red hot with a putter. Let's see what McIlroy does.
On fire right now. 7 under par.
Frank, the 15th here at the Old Course, just a classic example of Lynx golf, where you might be aiming for something that isn't even on the golf course.
Exactly. There's a nice line there. In between the two humps that you can see in front of you off the tee, if you keep looking down, you'll see the church steeple. That's the perfect line for the tee shot. Got to be careful with the second shot coming up. You see the 16th tee and out of bounds to the right of this green, and that little pot bunker that protects the front.
This could be really good, Frank.
Oh, straight at it.
And now it's right in his wheelhouse, good position where he can attack the pin.
Yeah, he has all those options now. That ball's sitting up, you can bring it in high, you can bring it in low. The choice is yours. This is not heading in the right direction.
No, it looks like it's going to be in the rough. Not the best shot, this one in the rough, but still will have a play from there.
Rich, that is annihilation on the golf ball.
Absolutely love it. I mean, he just tore that thing to pieces.
Shot now from the rough. Frank, what's he facing?
Well, the lie first and foremost. If it's sitting down, then obviously you're not going to get a very good contact. Nothing wrong with coming up a little bit short of the green. Problem is turning one mistake into another.
Not terrible, but not his best.
Yeah, outside chance, really, for birdie, but really, it was a rather poor approach shot.
Jordan Spieth, ready for his second shot. This one measures 130 yards. Frank, the beauty of the game, the changing conditions. You've played it all over the world, and you don't play it inside a dome, do you?
Yeah, anybody can play on a fine, still day, but what separates the good from the great is actually days like today. That's
needs a pair of binoculars to see the hole. Pretty good stroke right there. Just hit it through the break.
It's that sort of distance. If it goes in, it's a bonus.
You've got to be kidding me. That was right on the edge.
I tell you, he wants a do-over there.
Settles in over the putt. Continues to putt beautifully. Spieth has this for par. Just a couple of feet. So he has that for bogey. I can't help but think that the double bogey back on the 13th hole seems to have knocked him off his game. He is not playing well. So they'll tap in. Did the job right there. Frank, the 16th hole, there was a time in my life when I was in fourth grade, I would have really enjoyed hitting the principal's nose. But that's not a good thing here?
Well, I'd like to think you graduated past fourth grade, but, and if you did, then you'd be very aware of the principal's nose. You'd hit it left, it'd be a little longer in for your second shot.
But this one has a chance to be really good.
Frank couldn't ask for anything more.
Just the lie there, too. It is sitting up like it's teed up. There's a bunker over there.
I think he's headed for it.
Not quite what he was hoping for, the tee shot in the bunker.
Good spot right there.
Center cut.
All right, Frank, second shot.
Yeah, it looks like a good lie. Just take maybe half a club more than the distance allows. Still got to check the wind. Don't have to fly the ball all the way to the flag from here. That's as bad a shot as I've seen for a long while.
We are about 170 yards from the hole. Seems to like it. Looks like it's headed for the green.
Coming out of the rough and right up next to the hole.
Frank, for players looking to improve their putting, what are some of the training methods they can use?
I think speed is always is a good one when you get on the putting green and you just practice trying to putt inside that 3-foot circle. Because in the end, all sports are the same. You're trying to focus in on the destination where that ball has to be delivered, whether it's tennis inside the court or basketball inside the rim. Putting's no different. As you get further and further away from the hole, then you just make an acceptable size circle that you're trying to putt within. So pace. Very important.
Always two components to the long lag putt, the speed, number one, and then the read. And missed out on that second part.
Frank, I'm not saying he should pull out driver here, but this is a long putt.
Greens are fast, though. You never know. Good line, good pace. Might have a chance.
Just hammered that par putt, Frank.
Well, I don't know what he was thinking or what was going through his mind right there, but he better wake up in a hurry, because if this one doesn't go in, then that score's going to rack up very quickly.
Frank, we hear the sports psychologists say, forget about the bad shot, put it behind you. But you know, it just isn't that easy sometimes. You make the double bogey as he did on a previous hole, you're steaming mad. It's hard to let it go.
Well, it's like a lot of things in life, too. You got to choose whether you want to be your own friend or your own foe. And, you know, right now you can see that he's fighting himself, and that's the biggest difference. You got to realize your best friend out there is you.
Confidence right now clearly is shaken. Not a gimme, but well within his range. and he makes it for par.
Been pretty good all day from this distance, just trying to take care of business. Par for McIlroy, but you're just waiting for that moment when he hits that accelerator and pulls away. The famous 17th at the Open Championship, Frank, you begin to see the scoreboards, the grandstands, and you know all eyes are on you for the next couple of holes.
Yeah, this is one hole I think that anybody that goes to the Old Course certainly wants to play. Blind tee shot, you've got to flash it across the out of bounds and somehow find the fairway. If you go too safe down the left side, well, there's some heather to be chopping out of. Good tee shot certainly gives you a chance to hit at this beautiful green that's angled to the left, well protected by the road hole bunker. And if you're a little ambitious and a little strong, then there's a road itself and an out of bounds beyond this green. There's something about a well-hit shot.
Good strike, good lie, good chance to attack the pin. Pretty good drive here.
Another straight one.
There are a number of really good and important Grow the Game initiatives out there. One of those is the First Tee program, and that allows youngsters who otherwise might not have an opportunity, the chance to put a golf club in their hands, allows them the chance to pick up this game and learn some of the core values that come along with it. It's about much more than making a score. It's about integrity. It is about responsibility, values like that. And this game is just so good in instilling those kind of characteristics in young people. To where the hole is cut, just about 190 yards, Frank.
Good looking shot right here.
That's well played. Now a good look at birdie.
Second shot. Good look at the green.
Yardage book says 140, second shot. This is a cross-country special. Looks like he just misread that. Frank, this is a cross-country putt. He'll have a go at it, though, for birdie. We'll see.
There's no backing down here. This is going to go up and down and all over the place. But a chance to go in.
Well, there's an opportunity wasted.
Just knocking him for a par, and let's forget about this one. Golf is not about perfect. But it is going to hurt the course.
Well, you're not going to make that putt all the time, but you'd like to at least get it to the hole.
If he keeps putting like that, he's going to be an announcer in no time. That was a good run at it, Rich.
This one just requires a little bit of focus. Frank, that's not one you're necessarily thinking about making.
No, just a good putt, though. There's no two ways about that. He's putting well. No, Rich, that was a huge putt. You don't expect to make them from that distance.
Jordan Spieth trying to surrender just one shot. Now a 7-footer. Must make this for a double bogey. Well, once you hit double to par, it's time to just pick up and move on. Now at 1-under for the round. Frank, is there a more famous landmark in the sport than the tiny Swoken Bridge?
I think when you think of this game, the way in which we've followed it and covered it, Rich, over the last decade plus, no. It is just symbolic, not just with this golf course, but the game of golf itself, because every great champion has managed to make his foray across to Scotland and play the old course and walk across that bridge. Ooh, nice little bounce forward. Should be close to 300, 290.